Let us calculate the electric field strength due to a charge conducting a sphere using Gauss's theorem. Here this figure shows a uniformly charged isolated metal sphere in which the charge Q is uniformly distributed on its surface. And say, at a distance x from the center outside at a point P, we are required to find the electric field strength. Then in this situation, for use of Gauss law, we need to first consider a Gaussian surface. So here we consider a spherical surface in the surrounding of this conducting sphere, which is passing through point P, because this Gaussian surface will satisfy our condition that electric field will remain uniform, and at every point we can see, if we consider a small element ds, the area vector ds vector on the surface will be in radially outward direction, as well as electric field will also exist in radially outward direction. Then if we name the surface M, and we can say using Gauss law, for surface M, we get, if we apply the Gauss law for the total flux calculation, we can use integration of E dot ds, which is equal to net Q enclosed by epsilon naught. In this situation, we can see this E dot ds will become E ds, because at every point of the surface, electric field is parallel to the elemental area ds. So, E is also uniform. We can take this E common out. It is integration of ds for the surface M. And the total enclosed charge is symmetrically. It is Q only. So, it can be written as Q by epsilon naught. So, in this situation, we can write E multiplied by integration of ds. We can write as 4 pi x square. This will be Q by epsilon naught. So, this electric field we can write as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by x square, which can be written as KQ by x square, which we already studied earlier in the beginning of electrostatics. And here for x equal to, or this is the result which we are calculating for x greater than r. And for x equals to r, we can write this electric field as E is equals to KQ by R square. Similarly, we can solve it for electric field within the metal sphere. If we just find out electric field at a point P, which is inside the metal sphere, and if we consider a Gaussian surface passing through point P, and say this surface is L, then for this surface L, if we apply Gauss law, we can write for Gauss law at surface L, we can write it as integration of E dot ds for the surface L is equals to Q enclosed by epsilon naught. And here we can see by symmetry inside there is no enclosed charge, that means it must be equal to zero. So in this situation we can say here if integration E dot ds is zero, ds can never be zero. This implies electric field inside is equal to zero. And this we already studied in the beginning that for the case of a metal sphere, always the electric field inside is zero. In such a way, charge is distributed on it such that the inside electric field is equal to zero.